Hey everyone! You know, we see freight trains all the time. But have you ever really thought about what each car does or what kinds it holds? A gondola car is like a large roofless box. Its open top makes it perfect for carrying bulk cargo that isn't affected by weather, such as coal, gravel, minerals, and scrap metal. A hopper car looks similar to a gondola car, but it has a slope floor and gates at the bottom, allowing for easy discharge of free-flowing bulk cargo like grains or cement. A boxcar is fully enclosed with a roof and walls, protecting cargo from weather and dust. It's essential for safely transporting sensitive goods like packaged cement, paper, and home appliances. A tank car is a special cylindrical vehicle designed to transport liquids or gases. It safely carries hazardous or leak-sensitive materials such as petroleum and chemicals. A bulk cement tank car, also known as Aceman silo car, is used for transporting large quantities of powdered cement. It's designed for easy discharge from the bottom. You know those shipping containers we see everywhere? The container car is specially designed to move them. It uses in-wist lock mechanisms to securely fasten each container, ensuring safe delivery without any movement. An autorack is a multi-level car that can carry dozens of new cars at once. It's like a moving parking lot, efficiently transporting vehicles from factories to ports or dealerships. The flat car is pretty straightforward, just a simple, open, flat platform. That makes it perfect for really long or bulky cargo. Think containers, steel beams, construction materials, even military equipment. It's a versatile solution for oversized freight. A depressed center flat car has a recessed center, designed to carry extremely large and heavy loads that cannot be transported on regular freight cars, such as massive transformers. A caboose is a special car connected to the very end of a train. It serves as crew quarters and acts as a mobile command center for managing safety and responding to emergencies during hazardous material transport. So, there you have it. We've explored the specific names of those railway cars often simply called freight trains. While Korea's freight rail isn't as developed as in larger countries or open-bordered Europe, we can still imagine Korean freight trains bravely traversing Siberia all the way to Europe someday.